There were multiple reasons we made a change from Cedar. None of them are the number one reason why. It's just a combination of all of them. The first thing everybody thinks is the reason we did that is because it's cheaper. It's not necessarily cheaper. I was milling my own cedar at the same cost that I'm buying my pine today. So there really wasn't a cost reason that we made the change. One of the problems we deal with cedar is it's rough sawn. And what do I mean by that? Rough sawn means that it's not run through a planer. It has variances in its dimensions. So for example, if we were using a 2x4 that was supposed to be 1.5 inches thick, it really might be 1.375 inches, or it might be 1.625 inches, or it might be 1.916 inches. So it always varied because it was rough sawn. And so that made it very complicated for construction. It made it frustrating for construction. It made it frustrating to have a consistent product because the lumber dimensions were always different. Nothing was consistent. And so that was one of the problems we faced. Another one of the problems we ran into with cedar is supply. A constant supply of cedar was not available. Or if we wanted to import Western cedar, it became even more expensive. And so the inconsistency in the supply was a problem. There'd be months where we would have an abundance of cedar to work with, but there'd be other months where we were almost out of cedar and so that we couldn't really build the greenhouses we need to build. One of the other problems we dealt with cedar is it's not kiln dried. It's not ran through a drying process. So the lumber has a high moisture content. What that causes to happen is we'd build the beautiful greenhouse, then over a few months, that cedar would shrink. This perfect greenhouse that we had built several months down the road wouldn't look as perfect because it would shrink, there'd be gaps, the stain would not bond to the wood as well as we wanted it to because the moisture content in the wood would keep the stain from bonding, and as the wood dried out and the moisture left, the stain would go with it. And so that was another problem we dealt with cedar that caused us to look at making a change. Another one of the problems with cedar that we ran into, cedar's brittle. It cracks easy, it splits easy, it's not necessarily a strong wood. We would run a screw into the cedar and the wood would just split. And so you'd have to take that board off and you'd have to start over. And we dealt with that on a regular basis, the cracks in the cedar. So there's some great qualities to cedar. Cedar is certainly has a reputation for being a wood that will last longer, won't rot as easy. But all of the other problems in combination is what caused us to switch to a pine product.